Today we're going to electrocute a brand new iPhone 16 with a common household 9-volt battery. I've always wanted to say that. Specifically, we're going to electrocute the battery inside the iPhone 16 since it has an electrical debonding adherent under the battery where if we shock it with 9 volts, it should just fall away. Fun fact, and not many people know this, inside a 9-volt battery isn't just a singular coil like you might think, but actually 6 individual stacked battery cells all wired together to make that 9 volts. Tearing down a 9 volt battery isn't necessary for the iPhone battery removal process, I just like seeing how things are made and where energy comes from. And speaking of energy, lately I've been getting my energy from the nutritionally complete Huel Black Edition ready to drink bottles from my channel sponsor Huel. Keeping track of what I eat helped me lose about 15 pounds last year, and it's time for me to get back on track. Huel is calling their Black Edition ready-to-drink bottle Elite Nutrition, and I have to agree. Every bottle has 27 essential vitamins and minerals, with all the carbs and fiber to make a complete meal. With my favorite part, 35 grams of plant-based protein. And there's always the powdered mix. Conveniently blend your own powder, and each bag holds 17 meals ready to eat in less than 5 minutes. At exactly 400 calories, it makes calorie counting much more easy. I mix and match for lunch depending on the day and how much time I have. Also, these ready-to-drink bottles are now available at GNC stores, where you can just go in and buy some immediately. Because when you're hungry, you're hungry. You don't have to take my word for it though, Huel has sold more than 400 million complete meals in more than 100 countries. And if you don't enjoy it, there's a 30-day money-back guarantee. Strawberry is definitely one of my favorites. I'll leave a link for this drink down in the video description, or just head over to your local GNC and pick some up for yourself. Externally, the iPhone 16 looks nearly the same as every other iPhone released in the past 5 years, with 2 pentalobe screws at the bottom. Internally though, things are very different. The words Apple and repairable aren't normally spoken in the same sentence, but the world is changing. With those 2 screws gone and some heat from our heat gun, we can use a super strong suction cup to pull up on the glass. I did try to use 2 suction cups at once to see if I could grip the phone easier, but to no avail. The jerry-rig razor blade of truth has to come out to show the glass who's boss. Keep in mind, it is actually pretty difficult to slice away the adhesive without slicing away oneself. But eventually the phone opens. The main thing to look out for is the ribbon cable along the right side that goes out to the wireless charging coil. It's plugged in with a little Lego-style ribbon connector underneath the metal plate. After 2 tri-point screws are removed, I can unplug the single ribbon cable and remove the back rear glass. The glass still has its flash attached, and of course the coil and magnets for centering any wireless chargers that you might be using. The metal plate we took off was also covering the battery ribbon cable, which we can also unplug at this point. Now, here's where things are new. This iPhone 16 has a little tab down at the bottom, which at first glance looks like a pull tab, but is, in fact, the positive terminal for the battery adhesive, which is a sentence I never thought I would say. We can take our 9-volt battery, or any power supply between 9 volts and 30 volts, to accomplish the battery removal. The higher the voltage, the quicker the battery will fall away. Before electrocution, the battery is extremely secured and adhered in place. Prying this guy out safely by force alone would be impossible. If we attach the positive electrode to the terminal at the bottom of the battery, and the negative alligator clip to the screw near the USB-C port, we can let Thomas Edison do what he does best. The adhesive strip underneath that battery right now is apparently made with epoxy, laced with electrically conductive liquid, which is formulated so that electricity can break the adhesive bonds that are securing the battery to the phone. Attempting this on regular adhesive wouldn't do anything. Apple says this process takes about 90 seconds with those 9 volts, and just like all adhesives, it can take longer the older the adhesive is. So if you're repairing an iPhone 16 5 years from now, you might need to electrocute it for longer. And just like that, after 90 seconds, and the easiest peasiest of pries, the battery pops out all on its own, free from the iPhone housing. This might very well be the coolest thing Apple has ever done. No prying, no crying, no solvents, the battery is just out. All 3,561 milliamp hours of it. The silvery adhesive under the battery still has some sticky residue, but now that tackiness level just feels like a piece of scotch tape, instead of something that could hold an elephant to the ceiling. On the iPhone 16 side of things, it looks like this new battery adhesion solution adds an additional manufacturing process after the frame has been anodized. You can clearly see the marks left by the milling machine as it cut through the anodizing layer, probably so the adhesive could better conduct with bare aluminum. I'm not gonna lie, it is super cool to see. The two cameras up top, the 48-megapixel main camera and the 12-megapixel ultra-wide camera above it, both do not have any exterior optical image stabilization. Only the lower main camera has the internal sensor shift, which accomplishes the same thing. The other, second most popular repair that someone might want to attempt with an iPhone is a screen replacement. And Apple, who has been feeling extremely generous to us peasants lately, made this pretty easy as well. A well-trained, caffeinated technician could probably do a battery replacement in about 10 minutes, and a screen replacement can be accomplished in about that same amount of time. With a whole lot of heat and the finesse of a razor blade-wielding samurai, the adhesive can be gently sliced away from around the border. Anyone else attempting this method would probably lose a finger, but I've got a decade's worth of experience and currently have more fingers than I need. This time around, the screen opens to the left, just like a book, which is probably something you should pick up once in a while if you live here in the USA. With two more tri-point screws removed, and two more metal brackets gone, and two Lego-style ribbon connectors unplugged, the screen is now free to be swapped out and replaced. Apple makes all of their repair guides available for free on the internet, which is flabbergastingly impressive. I think Apple realized that the vast majority of people would never attempt something like this, so they just have nothing to lose. However, those new repair guides do go all the way back to the iPhone 12s, which can now be found for pretty cheap online. So buying an old broken phone and attempting to fix it, even just as a learning experience, is now pretty affordable, and I highly recommend it. Fixing stuff is a lost art these days, but it's one of the most useful skills a person can have, and the ladies love it. With the battery in place and the rear glass plugged back into the motherboard, the iPhone 16 still works, as I totally knew it would. If you want to see the insides of your smartphone from the outsides, there's always my teardown skins or grip case. Link is down in the description. And thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you around.